everyone. Thank you for joining me today for a short card tutorial. I do apologize for my, well, I was absent for a little bit. Like I said, I was out of the country and I am back. So I am getting back on track. So I appreciate you guys who had stopped by and, you know, just continue to look at my videos. Today, I'm going to be talking about the good old security envelopes. So I had an old one, and I guess something just went through my mind. I said, okay, let me see how well it will do if I cut it up. I was just messing around, and then what I found was it could actually make, you know, add a little bit of something to your card making. Now, here are a couple of ones that I had before, and I wanted you to see those. I also had one that had these, you know, strippy, well, lines in there. So I want to show you a couple of things you can do. So if you have any, like maybe you receive stuff with, from, mail or something, the security envelopes, why not just experiment and see what you can do? So I pretty much did a few of everything here. I also embossed the pieces just to give it a little more something. So I'm going to just go ahead and get it stuck on. And then we look at just a couple more options you can do. So this really is just playing around with security, the inside of security envelopes. And also, just so you notice on the edges here, it's black. I just used a ruler and a black marker to give it the effect of, you know, being a matted or what have you. Okay, then I went ahead and then added the this one, or well, I will actually add this one next to it. And then I will add this gray here. I had a gray piece, you know, of, well, it's cardstock, but it's mainly used, you know, with the wedding invitations and stuff. So I had a scrap here. And then I'm going to finally put this one on here. Okay. So let's get that together. Okay. So I ended up with this here, just so that we can see. And again, you know, just have fun with it. No biggie. I'm also going to go ahead and just lightly, you know, get the edges of this just, you know, with a little marker here just to kind of outline it a little bit without actually coloring it. So that it can just pop just a smidge. And this is a sentiment that I had, you know, just lying around that I wasn't using. So hopefully that'll be good. Okay, so, whoops, wrong one. So I'm going to go ahead and get this. As a matter of fact, I think I want to mount it instead for a reason. So I'm going to just grab some mounting squares for a second. And if I can find them. Okay, so I did get the mounting squares. Thank you, guys. I'm going to go ahead and use that instead. And you will see why in just a second. Because I want to use a couple of those flowers that I've been having, you know, just lying around. In that way, I have something. So I can get them under here. So I will place this, you know, pretty much in the center. Like so. And then I will use a couple of leaves here since I'm using green. I'm going to tuck some of those under the card. Oops. That's the other thing too. Depending on the paper, it might give you just a tad of a challenge to just stay stuck, but let's pretend it stays stuck. And then I will put this here. This flower right here. And then this final one, this is like a gold, just to give it just a smidge more oomph right in here. Just to come across as a bunch of flowers, okay? So pretty much that would be your matted piece, okay? Now, you can also go ahead and use, you know, I haven't done it, but I'm just going to give an example as well. I'm going to go ahead and cut this down using the, excuse me, using the envelope that I mentioned. I'm just going to cut a piece off. And then I'm going to run it through the, here I go again. I start with this forgetting what I'm trying to say thing. So I'm going to run this through the cuttle bug so you can see. So there's some different options. You don't, you know, you can use it any way you like, but I'm just saying these are a couple of options. And you can cut anything in it. Okay, so here is the piece. I'm just going to poke it out so that we can see. So if you know, the inside of the envelopes are really, really, you know, can do a little something to your card making too, just to add a little something different instead of throwing it out. So let's see how this came out. Now, it's very thin, so you have to also be careful. So here you are. So you see, you can do a lot of things with this inside. If you would like, you can stick it onto another piece of cardstock to give it a little more body for you to cut it through. But take a look at that. See, you can have some lovely die cuts. You can also cut shapes or hearts or use... the inside example, if you cut in a heart, you can cut the big heart with this and then a smaller heart to kind of, so this will kind of line the smaller one. So you can just be creative, okay guys? So thank you so much for watching, and I shall see you guys next week.